Hello there, music lovers and everyone who enjoys good audio. I'm Josh Modify Heaven and today we're having a look at Tempotec V1A or Tempotec Variations Player. This is a music player, but it is so much more than that, and this is an interesting one. This is one I am really excited about because it costs just $110. It is a very affordable DAP, but it has the features of a $300 DAP. Even the sound is pretty much in that ballpark, or at least in the $200 ballpark. So who is Tempotec? Tempotec is an OEM or producer of stuff who was originally producing stuff sold by HDZS. HDZS in the meanwhile acquired other OEMs and Tempotec started selling their own products. The first Tempotec product I have reviewed was the HDZS DH1000, which was also made by Tempotec, and they both sold it at different prices. Tempotec had it for cheaper, and a lot of people have asked me who is Tempotec and why. Tempotec makes an entrance on the audio market and a name for themselves with their V1A or V1 Variations DAP. What about the features, you may ask? Well, it has Bluetooth, both as a receiver and as a transmitter, so you can both power your Bluetooth earbuds or through wireless EMs, and you can also use it as a USB Bluetooth DAC. It also works as a USB DAC, as a Bluetooth DAC, it works as a USB DAC from your computer, even from your smartphone. I've been able to test that with my smartphone. The V1A even works with the Huawei P20, and that is really nice. I used a random cable, a random USB cable I had around, and they connected flawlessly. This one provided all the music and the fun. I have tested it with a number of EMs, from very affordable to very expensive EMs, and they all sounded amazing from the V1A. It actually sounds much better than I expected, and it has Hibi support, so it has the Hibi setting. You can actually configure the sound quite well. The unboxing is pretty simple. You have a lot of extras in the box though. You remove this part, which has the player itself, and it is placed in a little pouchy. This is the DAP itself. It comes with a screen protector applied. As you can notice, the screen protector is not so well applied, so the edges are starting to peel. You may want to search for one of those universal screen protectors and apply it and cut it in the size of the V1. The display is not as large as it may seem. This is not an entire display. Only half of this is a display. The other half is just empty space. I would suggest to the guys at Tempotec for the next release to use a larger display and to have the entire face of the DAP as a display rather than having just half of it, since this is a touch DAP and you are going to have a very small space to work with. There is a little wallet with the paperwork, so this is the certificate from Tempotec, and you also have other paperworks, but I usually test how intuitive something is by using it without reading the paperwork, and I'll tell you this, the V1A is very, very intuitive. I was able to enjoy it without reading all of that paperwork. I don't really like paperwork. I like diving right in, and then if I burn myself, I will check the paperwork. There is also a tiny box remaining inside the package. You can find the USB cable. I am not sure if this works as a data cable. From the looks of it, it looks like an OEM I have seen before. And this OEM did not work as a USB DAC. It only works for charging the device. But who knows, I will test this before publishing the full written review, and I will tell you there whether this one works as a cable for the USB DAC or not. This is the Tempotec V1A. It is so high-end and it is so good that it can even work with DSD files. So above everything I've told you about it, it can even decode DSD even natively.
This is the GUI or GUI or graphic user interface presentation of the Tempotec Variations V1A. The overall system is quite simple actually, and although you can only use half of the display, so this is the only half you are able to use, it is a pretty practical design. You have settings where you can select the language, update the music database, and you can turn it into low power mode, which basically means that the battery will survive a bit longer. There is a variation of color themes, so you can customize it a bit if you need it to, and you can increase the font size if you can't quite see it. You can also increase the brightness if you need to, and it works as a USB DAC. I know that it has a firmware update option, but it is not very likely that the firmware will receive many updates in the future, so I wouldn't get my hopes too much up if you don't quite like the current firmware, although the TempoTech may fix some of the issues that are existent with the V1A. There is an about option which tells you the current serial number and the current firmware you are running of the TempoTech V1A. You can also select the play settings, which lets you select how to play, and it has a playthrough list option. It has a line out and the headphone output mode. You can resume play from the last position if you want to. It has gapless playback, it has DSD, it has a fixed power on memory, which means that it will always turn to the same power volume it was. It has crossfade, it has gain, which is on high for most practical uses. It also has even replay gain, and you can balance it between the left and the right channel if you happen to have a slight hearing imbalance. It can play through folders and it can even play through albums. This is one of the most complete DAPs I have seen on the market. Although the user interface is made by Hibi, it is actually a bit better than most Hibi DAPs are. It has an equalizer, which is not quite as practical as it seems, because after you turn it on and you start playing with it, you realize that it is not sensitive enough to the touch and the display is quite small, so setting the equalizer can be a bit of a hassle. I don't really like the overall experience with that. I would typically just use the MSAB or a MSAB, which allows you to use Hibi's high quality equalizer, and once again it is better to not use very high changes. I usually leave it on fine tune, because on fine tuning you get the most out of it. If you go to middling or excessive, you are going to pretty much break every single type of sound there is. Fine tune for the MSAB or MSAB. Next up, you have the Bluetooth settings. And it has Bluetooth. It has a blue LED at the top, which lights up if you are using the Bluetooth mode, and that is quite handy as well. The Bluetooth allows you to both use it as a USB receiver and as a USB DAC. You can even send signal to your Bluetooth EMs or such, like the Pamu Slide Mini or the LiperTech Tevi or the Master & Dynamic MW07 Go or the Master & Dynamic MW07 Plus or any other true wireless EM you want. I typically browse by folder. I do not really open the category browsing. I have my microSD card in the second slot, and I have a pretty large collection of music to show you how well it handles large collections. So, as you can see, it works pretty well. I have a very large collection here, and it loads it pretty quickly. As you can see, you can actually browse to it pretty quickly. It doesn't freeze. Once you have selected the song, it doesn't go to the now playing option. To do that, you need to swipe from the right to the left, like this. After you have swiped from the right to the left, you see the main screen. This folder in particular does not have any cover art, so you are not seeing anything else but the default, and there is no more swiping. You can favorite a song and you can use the type of play you want. You cannot drag the top bar, but you can drag from the bottom up, where you have a few options like the gain, the DAC type, the USB, and you can increase or decrease the brightness, which isn't a good idea. I would typically leave the brightness at maximum. And you can also quickly increase or decrease the volume. This is not practical at all, because it has a lot of driving power, and increasing the volume may blow your eardrums out. To get out of this, you need to push it back down. You can slide from the left to the right to go back in menus, and that is pretty much the navigation of it.
What else can you want from an DAP which is priced at the $110 price range? This is just insane. The guys at TempoTech are really making the fight hard for everyone, and I like that. I really like that. We will be seeing much better products at much lower prices. Right now, the TempoTech V1A is one of the easiest to recommend DAPs in the entire world. For $110, you get good sound, lots of driving power, Bluetooth, USB DAC, even a phone DAC, and even two microSD slots. What is this? Why are they making it so awesome? I am actually confused by how much effort they put in it. The software is typical Hibi. The software works good enough for me to be able to recommend it. There is just this screen on the Tempotec View 1A, so you don't have much else going on. It's just this part that is the display, and only this part registers touch inputs. I felt that was a bit of a letdown because the display is small, but given the number of overall abilities it has and the price of $110, this is just great. I will not complain one bit. It does not have streaming, but since it can work as a Bluetooth and as some smartphone USB, that you can stream music through Tidal or other apps from your smartphone. It actually has a very good driving power. It has the MSAB or the MZEB, this is how it is called, from Hibi. This is basically a very, very fancy looking equalizer. It allows you to change the sound of the Tempotec View 1A, or rather it allows you to make profiles for your EMs and headphones. This is the best implementation of an equalizer that I have ever seen in my entire life. It works absolutely amazing. It allows you to either fine tune or make major changes to the sound, but given the very small display, it is a bit inconvenient to set it through the Tempotec View 1A, so you are going to have a bit of an issue dragging the sliders across. The overall sonic quality of the View 1A is pretty easy to change since it has so many equalizer options, but I would describe the original or the default state as being slightly warm. It is a pretty warm overall sound, but it has very good detail. It has a wider presentation. It is more wide than it is deep. It has a very, very good driving power. At the volume set to 40 to 50, it can drive Mezerai Penta, and that is a very good thing. It can also work with true wireless EMs, and I have been able to connect it to the PAMU Slide Mini that worked very well with the Tempotec View 1A, and it has only a 3.5mm jack at the bottom. There are no balanced outputs at this point. I would compare it even to Fios BTR5. It has a pretty similar overall sound and a pretty similar overall size even and shape, we could say that, but the BTR5 has a bit more driving power on the balanced output, while the View 1A has no balanced output. On the other hand, the View 1A has 2 microSD slots, which is more than any single smartphone on the market has. This could be your dream transport if you wanted to. It has Hibi Link, so you could control it from your smartphone using Hibi Link through the Bluetooth, which means that you could have your headphones connected to it, drop it in a bag or in a backpack, and you are going to be able to control it from your smartphone. It has button controls, and the volume button controls are wrong on mine. I find that pretty funny and ironic. The button on the bottom is plus and the one on the top is minus, but they work the other way around. Pressing the one on the bottom actually decreases the volume and the one on the top increases it. That's just a funny coincidence. I don't really mind it, but it is something to take into account. There are 3 navigation buttons as well, which work flawlessly even while you have true wireless earphones attached. All in all, the View 1A is one of the best DAPs if you need a very, very affordable one. So when I say best, I mean in this price range. I always mean in this price range. You need to consider that if I don't explicitly say that it is best regardless of the price range, it is always from its own price range. At the $110, I don't really have what else to recommend you to beat the View 1A from Tempotec. As far as disadvantages go, the battery life is not incredible. It has a modest battery life. I'm still running a few tests, but the battery life did not impress me very much, and I actually noticed that it is a bit buggy. So the UI is not exactly the smoothest, it is not exactly the fastest, it is much more laggier than Fio M3 Pro or other DAPs, but it is acceptable. I will be honest with you, I can live with that UI. The UI is good enough for my daily usage. It is not perfect, that much is clear, but it is good, it is okay. On the other hand, it has a ton of advantages, and I can't even mention all of them in just one video. It has Bluetooth. It has two-way Bluetooth because it has Bluetooth 5. It can act as a recorder and as a transmitter for Bluetooth. It has 2 microSD cards, which is another amazing thing. It has enough power to drive even full-sized headphones, the easier to drive ones, but still it has the power to do that. It has the best EQ in the world, Hibi's implementation. It has a touch screen, and it is based on touch, although the display is a bit small. And overall, I'm just pleased with this DAP. I'm really pleased with it. It is a mini DAP that will really justify the asking price. For $110, I would pay that money for it. I would consider it a very good deal and I wouldn't look back. I would consider this to be a very good deal in 2020. Although it is a bit retro and old style to have a DAP, and it doesn't have quite the quality of your M11 Pro, for example, and it doesn't really have the quality of iBase or the X160 either, but in the $110 price range, it is a very, very rich setup because it is rich of features. I hope this video has been enjoyable to you as it has been for me to make. I hope you'll press that like button if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to Audiophile Heaven for more content on audio products. I hope you have a lovely weekend there and we'll see each other really, really soon. Bye bye.